Racing to the 2023 Kentucky Derby, and this time we go to Dubai for the UAE Derby 2023. They did draw the field. A field of 11 has entered. They are going to be going a mile and 3/16, a large purse in Dubai, and of course 100 points on the line to the winner, possibility of getting into the Kentucky Derby. Now, traditionally, some of the UAE Derby horses have disappointed in Kentucky, but in recent years, some of the Japan runners have been targeting this race. We also have a deep contingent of American horses this year, although I think the quality of, overall of the Americans are a little bit lighter. Let's take a look at this 11-horse field. Starting at the rail, we've got S. Unico, who draws the rail in an 11-horse field. Odd G's, 9 starts, trained by Doug O'Neill, by Mendelson, one of the American horses shipping over there. You've got Cairo. Now this one I think is going to take a little bit of the money, going to be one of the favorites. Quality Road is the sire, classic American pedigree. This one goes for a homebred for Aiden O'Brien and Coolmore. 5 starts, 3 wins, picked up a win in a prep race his last time out. Overall, a little bit of quality, does have a couple of stakes wins, including a grade 3 for Cairo. Continuar is one of the 5 Japan horses in the race. Definitely a contender here, along with Derma Sogataki, Dura Aridi, and Go Soldier Goal, who has a win on March 4th at Maiden. And then you've got Gareiko, another Japan horse, Laresh, Mr. Raj, and Perriere rounds out the 11-horse field. I did want to talk about Perriere. 4 starts in his lifetime, 3 wins, does have a win in the highest Senesse Stakes the last time out. And what I like about him is his pattern. He's got 3 races as a 2-year-old in 2022, and then he's got 1 race this year on February 19th in Tokyo, picked up the win, and a little bit of an American slanted pedigree by Henny Hughes. That brings some speed. Of course, Henny Hughes was a horse trained by Dwayne Lucas back in the day, but the mare is from Japan and the broodmare sire is from Japan, and we're seeing a lot more pedigree influence, not only Japan runners this year, they are being bred in Japan. So I think this 11 horse field probably has the deepest contingent of Japan runners. Perriere could possibly win. You've got Continuar. A horse like Cairo is going to take some money, and then Tallboy had a nice prep over the track. So I do think some of the race favorites are going to be Worcester for Bob Baffert, Cairo, Go Soldier Gold, Tallboy, Perriere, and Continuar as some of the race favorites. But let's take a look at some of these individually. You've got Cairo, again by Quality Road, 5 starts, 3 wins, Aiden O'Brien, Ryan Moore gets the mount. He won the Patton Stakes, he won the Kilovan Stakes, a grade 3, Cairo, one of the top contenders. Tallboy goes for Doug O'Neill, he's by Looking at Lucky. Of course, he won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile a few years back on the synthetic. 5 starts, 1 win. He did win the UAE 2K. That was a grade 3 race last out for Tallboy. Of course, Odgies, another one for Doug O'Neill. Tyler Gaffleone picks up the mount for Odgies. A little bit of a long shot in this race. Not sure he wants the mile and 3/16 distance. Worcester, still a maiden. Of course, this horse trained by Bob Baffert. And, you know, I think he's going to show a little bit of speed in this race, because sometimes this race doesn't get a lot of speed. But some of the Japan runners are starting to show a little bit more speed. Last year, we had a very fast pace in Dubai, and those horses came over and contributed some speed in the Kentucky Derby, kind of setting it up for a closer. Now, Go Soldier Goal is another one who could parlay a victory here. I think they would be thinking Kentucky Derby. I think Tallboy would be for Calumet Farm. Cairo, the early indications are if he can get a win in this race, he might consider an effort over in Kentucky for Louisville. So we'll see if any of these horses come on over. But again, last year we had Crown Pride coming over from Japan, and we'll see if we can get one of these Japan runners to come over here this year. I think my top selection in the UAE Derby is going to be Perriere. I just like the pattern. I like the Henny Hughes on the sire side, and then some of that distance and class stamina on the Japan side. A long shot in this race, I think I'm going to go with Continuar, continuing some of the trends here of the Japan runners. They have really pointed for this race this year. I don't think Tallboy can get the distance. Cairo is worth a little bit of a shot if you're looking at some multi-race wagers and want to include a couple of other horses, but I really think the Japan contingent is tough this year, and they may be showing some speed. I'm going to go with my top selection as Perriere in the 2023 UAE Derby. Don't forget, we've got previews up with the Louisiana Derby. That race is already up, that preview. A deep field of 12 horses entered for that race. We're going to have a preview on Wednesday up of the Jeff Ruby Stakes. 9 to 10 horse field expected for that. Of course, next week we got the Arkansas Derby and the Florida Derby as we get closer to the 2023 Kentucky Derby. Don't forget, if you like Derby news and notes and updates on the upcoming Triple Crown races, I do publish the Derby prospectus every Monday, 2,000 words. This week we talked about all of the final round of preps, but see the description in the link below to subscribe for free every week, the Derby prospectus 2023, as we get you ready for the 2023 Kentucky Derby.